When we talk about ethnic cleansing, we tend to think of Nazi Germany and concentration camps. But what if I tell you, one of the most atrocious ethnic cleansing campaigns happened much closer to home, in the Americas. In 1915, the mulatto population on the western part of the island of Hispaniola, now known as Haiti, successfully killed and dismembered their president, Guillaume Vilbrun Sam. Hearing of the news, U.S. President Woodrow Wilson took it as an opportunity to invade not only the western part of the island, Haiti, but the eastern part as well, Dominican Republic. Under the guise of maintaining political stability, the U.S. proceeded to install U.S.-friendly governments, which tend to manage United States interests rather than the populations. While being in Hispaniola, the U.S. created a white superiority complex in both parts by elevating lighter-skinned Haitians and Dominicans in prominent positions while suppressing the darker-complected ones. The effects of U.S. treatments of dark-skinned people on the island created the pathway for the 1937 Haitian massacre to take place. After the departure of U.S. troops from the island, many Dominican elites saw Haiti as a racial threat that imperiled both political and commercial relations with white European nations. In 1930, Dominican President Horacio Vazquez was overthrown by the chief of his army, Rafael Leonidas Trujillo Molina. His 31 years in power, to Dominicans, known as the Trujillo era, or El Trujillato, are considered to be one of the bloodiest eras ever in the Americas. Despite being a quarter Haitian himself, Trujillo saw the presence of a bicultural Dominican and Haitian borderland to be a threat to his power and an escape route for political opponents. On October 2, 1937, Trujillo made his intentions towards the Haitian community clear in a brief speech he gave during a celebration in his honor in the province of Dajabon. Claiming to be protecting Dominican farmers from theft and incursions, Trujillo revealed the killing of 300 Haitians along the border in Bonica and promised to continue to remedy the situation. Between October 2nd and October 8th, hundreds of Dominican troops, who came mostly from other areas of the country, poured into the region. These armed forces killed Haitians with rifles, machetes, shovels, knives, and bayonets. Haitian children were reportedly thrown in the air and caught by soldiers' bayonets, then thrown on their mothers' corpses. Some died while trying to flee to Haiti, across the Massacre River that divides the two nations. Survivors who managed to cross the border and return to Haiti told stories of family members being hacked with machetes and strangled by the soldiers, and children bashed against rocks and tree trunks. The military targeted black Haitians, even though many Dominicans were dark-skinned themselves. To distinguish between Haitians and Dominicans, the killers forced their victims to say the Spanish word for parsley. When confronting someone in the lands along the border with Haiti, the killers would hold up a sprig of parsley and ask what it was. If the person responded by trilling the R in perejil, Spanish for parsley, he would be free to go. Anyone who didn't trill the R was thought to be a Haitian Creole speaker and would be killed. The Dominican government censored any news of the massacre, while they continued to throw bodies of Haitians and Haitian descendants in ravines, in rivers, and burning many of the corpses. It is estimated between 5,000 and 67,000 Haitians died in the infamous Parsley massacre. Justice was never served, and amends were never made, despite the fact that those two nations shared the same island since the beginning of their history. Till this day, many Dominicans still view Haitians along the borders as a threat. Trujillo was eventually assassinated by his own people in 1961 with the help of the CIA, but unfortunately, his ideology still lives on. This can be attested by witnessing the attitude of modern-day Dominicans towards the Haitians that lives in the east part of the island.